Hello. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install QFTest on your system and how to apply for a trial license and how to activate a trial license to test QFTest for your applications. As first step, I will fetch the installation package of QFTest, which I can download from the webpage of QFS www.qfs.de. There I can immediately find the button Free Download, which leads me to the downloading area of QFTest. Here I can choose between several installation packages. Windows users can download a Windows installer or a self-extracting archive provided for Linux users, and Mac users can find a disk image there. As I'm working on a Windows system, I choose the Windows installer, finally pressing save on my browser to trigger the download. While the download of QFTest is running, I can request a trial license. A trial license allows to use all capabilities of QFTest for 4 weeks, and I can also save my test suites and so on. I could use QFTest without a trial license, but then I'm not allowed to save anything. That's why I press Request Free Trial License, and on the registration form, I will enter the data which is required to create a trial license. In order to establish a clear and an efficient communication, it's necessary to submit an email address and, if possible, a phone number. Once the trial license has been created, it will be sent to that email address stated on this form. If I already knew the utilized technologies in my project, I can select the according checkbox. In my case, I want to test a web application. If you cannot recall the technologies of your project, it's no problem, because a trial license supports every supported technology of QFTest. Finally, I want to get some announcements of QFS whenever something happened with that tool. And I select where I heard of QFTest. In my case, it was an internet search. Now I want to submit that request, pressing Request License. My request has been received by QFS, and now a member of the QFS license team will create the trial license. Afterwards, he will send that license directly to my email address. By the way, I also received an email from QFS telling me that the license request has been received and a member of the license team will take care about it. While the license is being created, I will install QFTest using the recently downloaded installer. Therefore, I switch into the downloads folder of my system where I can find the installer file. Please note that the installation process requires administrator privileges on your Windows system. If your current user doesn't have such permissions, please contact your system administrators in your company or download the self-extracting archive of QFTest from the webpage. I start the installation via a double click on the installer file now. As the installation process requires administrator privileges, Windows shows the user account control dialog, which I have to confirm in order to allow the installation. So I say yes in order to proceed. Now we reach the first dialog of the installation, which is actually the selecting setup language page. So I can select whether I want to proceed in English or in German. Of course, I stay in English for that installation and I say OK. Now I can walk through the license agreement of QFS, just read it, and finally I can accept it and press Next. As next step, I can configure the installation folder of QFTest. The default installation folder of QFTest follows the Windows default, so you can simply proceed with that. Now I can configure whether I would like to get a shortcut in my Windows Start folder for QFTest. That's pretty good in order to find QFTest pretty fast. So I can say next. Now I can configure whether I would like to have a desktop icon in order to start QF test. That's also a good idea. So I keep the checkbox checked and press next. Finally, I get a summary page, which allows me to review all the settings which I have performed. So the installation file folder and the create desktop icon task, which is okay. So I start the installation now by pressing install. Once the installation has finished, I can check two additional checkboxes. The first option allows me to configure the used Java program and the memory of QFTest, and the second one will start QFTest subsequently. I check both because I would like to configure Java and I would like to run QFTest afterwards. So I press finish, and now I reach the Java configuration dialog of QFTest. QFTest requires an installed Java in order to start up, but QFTest also comes with its own Java version, so you can simply keep use QFTest Java there, and configuring an alternative Java is only required in very, very rare use cases. Furthermore, we can configure the memory of the QFTest process, and we can configure the language which we would like to use to start QFTest. In my case, I keep English and press OK. As next step, we get a Windows security alert on Windows boxes. That's because the QFTest Java wants to connect to the network in order to perform the check of the license usage. So here we can allow the access because we would like to check QFTest its own license usage. Please take care that this process also requires administrator privileges. And now we reach the dialog of cannot locate license of QFTest, which comes because we haven't installed a QFTest installation yet. Okay, but what can we do now? We can start QFTest directly without a license. We can request a trial license, but what we have already done so far. Or we can activate a license once we have the license already received. I want to take a look at QFTest now, so let me run QFTest without a license. On the first startup, QFTest asks me whether I would like to get informed by QFTest updates. This seems to be a very useful feature, so I enable the update check. And whenever QFTest releases a new version, I will get informed now. Now I reach the main window of QFTest, and I can start creating the first test cases or walk through the documentation like the tutorials or some sample test suites. As I haven't activated my license yet, I cannot save anything. Saving is only allowed if a license is being activated. So let me check my mailbox for the trial license now. And here we are, I have received my trial license. The email describes how to install the license, and I save the attached license file to my system now to the downloads folder. Switching back to QFTest, I can activate the trial license by the menu action Help Activate or Update License. On that dialog, I can select the recently saved file now via Select File. Then I switch to the Downloads folder. I select the recently stored license file, press Open. Here I see the details about my license. I press Update in order to update the license. Now I get the details of my license, the expiration date, and so on. I say yes. And once the license has been updated completely or activated in the QFTest terms, I get a dialog that it's been activated and stored to that particular folder. Pressing OK confirms that updating process. And now the license is activated and I can go ahead with QFTest and also save my test suites. If I want to check the details of the license file once again, like the expiration date or the utilized technologies, I can go to Help Info on the menu. And there I see the details of the license once again, and I can also find the location of the license file itself. If you are interested in any other installation folders and directories QFTest is using, you can select the System Info dialog, and there you see all of the directories used by QFTest. So what have we seen on this video? Installing QFTest and activating a trial license is really simple. The installation process on Linux and Mac is as simple as on Windows. The installation processes there also follows the typical operating system standards. As next step, check out the other videos on this channel or the provided self-starter tutorial of QFTest to create your first test cases. Enjoy working with QFTest.